What's up, guys? This is Jason Ryan for Hollywood.TV, and we're at the second series premiere for FX's hit series, The Bridge. And how great is it to be on a show that's, I mean, it's such a dark and intense show, but so incredibly well written and critically acclaimed, and, you know, huge fan support as well.
It's an honor, and it's a thrill, and it's sort of everything that you hope for as an actor, to be on a wonderfully crafted show, and it's great. And it shoots in LA. It's great, and it's on FX, which I think is making, you know, the kind of the boldest television around.
For me, it's a dream gig. You know, it's I'm representing some folks that I love dearly, and that I get to portray them realistically on the big screen, which is great. On a show that nobody else is doing, showing both sides of the border, no matter how ballsy, no matter how ugly, what's going on with illegal immigration since NAFTA, and what we're doing about it, and all those things. I don't know that I've seen a show. It's why they want a Peabody. I guess I can say we want a Peabody. I've never seen a show that be that honest about what it's really about. Yeah.
What can we expect out of your character for season two? You know, there's a hints of him like wanting to get out of there, but is he going to get sucked back into everything in season two?
Yeah. Yes, he is. I think that in a big sense, I think that Hank has been able to avoid drama in his personal life, which is one of the things that really appealed to me about this cop character. He wasn't divorced, and he wasn't, he was regular guy. Yeah, which I think is a much fairer depiction of law enforcement in this country, you know. But being on the border and being embroiled in this and being a good man, he's come across some things that where he needs to challenge his, he needs to question his own perception of his country.
Wait, how exciting is it to work on a show that's such critically acclaimed and such great writing?
It's a dream come true. Is that the ultimate cliche thing to say? It is. Yeah. It really is. There isn't shows out there like this. They're very limited, so it's very much a blessing. I understand that I am in a great position, and that it's very, again, like I said, it's very, very rare to be in the shoes that I'm standing in right now. So I'm very lucky.
It's a really deep show, but most of your scenes are with Matthew Lillard, who I'm assuming helps bring some levity to how dark your scenes are.
Matthew Lillard, it doesn't matter if we're in a funeral, it doesn't matter if we're, I don't know what it is that we are doing, but he is always living it up, and it doesn't matter if it's 3 o'clock in the morning, 10 o'clock at night when we're filming, he has the same amount of energy, he's always bouncing off the walls. It always makes it fun to look forward to coming to work every day. You're like, really, this is my job, I get to play and tell jokes with this guy? I mean, it's pretty awesome.
And this season is way, way more interesting, and the new characters, and I never expected what I was reading in the scripts. So I think it's going to be really good.
For your own character? Because your character is very dark. It got very dark for your character in season one. Yeah.
Well, I think it's still dark because the show is dark, you know, but it gets really interesting for Eva and for everyone else.
I mean, what's the most important thing that you've learned about what happens on the border from working on the show?
Well, I am originally from Monterrey, Mexico, which is only a couple of 100 miles from the Texas border. So I've seen what this has done. Like, Monterrey is a city of 6 million people. It used to be one of the safest cities in Mexico. But with all the territory drug wars that have been going on, it turned into chaos, basically. So I've seen personally what the situation.
You still have family?
Yeah, I have family. I have family in Monterrey.